If you've been sent a document that needs some quick cleanup or finished writing up a proposal with tables and graphs but dreading the proofreading process, the ruler in Microsoft Word will make quick work of your manual tasks. With the ruler, you can set margins, indent text, create tab stops, adjust table columns, align objects, and even measure items in your document. Whether you're a student, a professional, or just someone who prefers Word over other applications, the ruler feature is definitely worth exploring for all the format power that comes with it. The first thing we'll tackle is the setup process of the Microsoft Word ruler. While yours may already be set up by default, you can customize it to your liking. If you're already comfortable with tab stops and your ruler is already displayed, feel free to skip ahead. You can see that my document is missing the ruler, so to show it, I'll look under the View tab and check the box labeled Ruler. Under the ribbon, the ruler appears, and we can see that our margins are set to the standard 1 inch from the left and right borders. But before we start using the ruler to make changes, let's finish with the setup. If you don't see the vertical ruler to the left, you can fix that by opening the Options menu under the File tab and selecting Advanced. Scroll down to the Display section and check off the box to show vertical ruler in Print Layout View. We also have the option to change our units of measure. In this dropdown, you can change inches to centimeters, millimeters, or any of the available options. When you're done, click OK, and you should now see the changes applied to your document. Take note of the tab stop in the left-hand corner of your view. A tab stop is used to tell Word where you'd like the cursor to jump to when the tab key is pressed. By default, we have this little L icon. This means your tabs are set to the left, and when applied, your text will move to the right as you type. But there are 6 other options available, and you can cycle through each by clicking on the tab stop. I'll show you some of these, but here's a quick roundup. You can also change the defaults of the tab stop and its measurement by opening the paragraph window under the Home tab and selecting the Tabs button at the bottom. But let's get to what you're here for, how to use the ruler in Microsoft Word. Looking at both the vertical and horizontal rulers, you'll see these dark gray areas to the sides, and these indicate the margins of your document. You can adjust your margins from the ruler by placing your cursor in the middle of the margins border until you see the double-sided arrow. Then drag the margins to where you'd like. If you prefer exact measurements instead of eyeballing the change, you can hold the Alt key as you move the arrow, and your ruler will display the measurements. Any change you make to the margins will apply to the entire document. This includes the vertical margins as well. If you decide you don't like the placement, you can choose one of the defaults by opening the Margins dropdown under the Layout tab. I'll just stick with the normal 1-inch margins for now. If we want to change the indentations of the document, we can use the arrow icons on the ruler. On the left side, there's the first line indent marker, the hanging indent, and the left indent marker. On the right side of the ruler is the right indent marker. Let's say we wanted this first paragraph to appear more centered and compact for design purposes. Instead of changing the margins, which would affect the entire document, we can move the indent markers. Just place your cursor anywhere within the paragraph, grab the left indent marker at the bottom, and pull it across the ruler. You can do the same for the right indent marker. The ruler in Word is always aware of your cursor's placement, so any indentation change you make will only apply to a structured paragraph or single line. You can make changes to the entire document at once by pressing Ctrl+A to highlight all text. Now moving the left indent location will cover all sections. This looks a little funny, but you get the idea. I'll move the indents back to normal and we can experiment with some other examples. Here's a quick way to clean up a rigid-looking wall of text. I want to take the body of my file and add some common first line indentation. Instead of pressing Tab at the start of each paragraph, simply highlight the range and drag the first line indent marker to the right. Another handy function of the ruler is the hanging indent marker. This will control the indentation of a section of text after the first line. When I was in school, I would use this all the time for listing references in the correct format. I only have one reference listing long enough in this file to make use of it, but let's give it a go. Place your cursor anywhere in the section of text. Then click and drag the hanging indent marker to the location you prefer. You can also use the tab stop feature to get the same result. Let's go ahead and center the headings of the document using the tab stops. First, click the tab stop icon until you get the center option. Now insert the tab stop into the ruler. You can place it anywhere you'd like, just know that it doesn't center the text of the document. It centers the text relative to the marker. But to insert the marker, Click the desired location on the ruler, and you'll see the tab stop icon sitting there. Again, the cursor position matters. It will only apply to the row you have selected. You can highlight the whole document or just all headings in this instance. Once the tab stop is in place, click your mouse at the start of your row and hit the tab button. If you're about to start a new document, you can set your tab stops ahead of time to make the process more efficient. Here I'll insert two left tab stops, a decimal tab, and a center. Now as I begin entering text, each time I hit the tab key, my boundaries are set. First, I'll hit tab 4 times and enter my title under the center tab stop. Pressing enter to go to the next row, you can still see the tab stops in place. I'll now add the headers for each list to be filled out, hitting the tab key after each entry. You can do this all throughout the document, and if you need to adjust their locations, simply drag them over. Just remember to highlight the entire section, or you'll only adjust the measurement of one row. And to remove or edit one or more tab stops completely, you can navigate back to the Layout tab and open the Paragraphs window, or you can double-click on one of your tab stop icons in the ruler. All your tab stops will show in a list, and you can press Clear All to remove them, or select the ones of interest and clear them or edit. In this case, I'll pick my decimal tab stop and change it to the center tab stop. Click OK and the change has been applied. Keep in mind that removing or changing tab stops will not change the location of your indent markers. And make sure you've made your edits with the intended area highlighted. Otherwise, it'll only be applied for that line. I may sound like a broken record, but you'd be surprised how often this gets overlooked. There's no doubt using the ruler in Word will save precious time for more important things. If Microsoft Word is your go-to text application, let me know in the comments which feature you'd like to learn more about. Maybe converting a PDF document into an editable Word file. If so, check out this video here and stop paying for that product license you only use for once a month.